Network. Manager Jim Leishman reshuffles his team after last week's cup draw with Hamilton. Rugby moves to central defence, Cosmo wears six, and O'Boyle comes back into the attack. And a key player for Dunfermline this season has been Ross Jack. His 14 goals have been invaluable, and he scored against Rangers on their last visit to East End Park. League leaders Rangers are without captain Kerry Butcher, and his replacement is Scott Nisbet at number six. John Brown continues to wear number 11. Rangers currently in a 9-game unbeaten league and cup run, and playing a vital role for the Light Blues has been keeper Chris Wood. 619 minutes of league football without conceding a goal and producing an important save at key moments. Match official for today, Bob Patterson of Nielsen. And the game underway. Coyce and Johnston, the Rangers strike force, contributing 28 goals for Rangers this season so far, and looking for more today. Stephen looking very eager. So the Spackman. Brown, 28 years of age yesterday. Johnston beaten in the air by Rugby. Spackman bringing a little bit of order in the midfield as Monroe's testing ball searches out from Thurman defence. Stephen. Rugby did very well to cover. Obviously not pleased with the linesman and the referee's decision, but clearly was a corner. Rangers have Nisbet and Goff up in the box. And it was Nisbet's header. Walter! But it's been chopped off. And although Walters did have the ball in the net, the whistle had gone for an earlier infringement, and the goal was cancelled out. Nisbet losing out to the challenge of Robertson. Again, Rugby fight commanding in the air, but illegally getting up to beat Johnston on that occasion. Good positive challenge there by McCarthy, the corner save. Rangers still in possession, and that was a late challenge. And Mr. Patterson is pulling over George O'Boyle. Looks like a booking for the Irishman. Late challenge. Johnston on the far side of the box. Didn't reach him. Thurman's back in strength. Cosma picking up the chance here. The early ball is dangerous. Well cut out. Cool bit of play there by Gary Stevens. Cosma showing his skills here, and the early ball simply caused problems. Fairland's first corner. Wood took it so cleanly, showing just how confident the big Englishman is. Back to his best form. Cassie there to steer it back safely for the Fairland. Working a good triangle down the right side, drawing Monroe forward, and he had to get back sharp there because O'Boyle is quite a speed merchant. so close. Cosma. And this was down to a boil, turning ground, a fine centre, and Cosma powered the head of very, very close.
Getting very good distance. Jack winning that one.
Well, they'll still keep possession. This to Nickel, bit tight. And Rowe kicks his head. Wilkerson to fourth. The hoist is not offside. Takes on McCarthy. Stephen. Well cut out there. Good play by Davy Irons for Dunfermline. Prevented Trevor Stephen from getting the shot in and goal. Dunfermline get a little bit of space in midfield. Robertson. Cosma dropping back. Jack going forward, but Golf was there. Rookney. Robertson again. Overhitting everyone. Go back acknowledging Rookney's service. At full stretch. Rugby and Nickel. Spackman winning vital ball for Rangers in midfield. Gary Stevens. Good ball by Nisbet and Stevens through. The scorer, but set up by Scott Nesbitt. Scott Nesbitt coming into the side, and what a beautiful pass. Stevens kept running, and he drilled it through the keeper. Rangers ahead, 1-0. So Rangers ahead after 15 minutes. One rather fortuitous for Rangers. Twice to support Walter. Again, Nisbet at the far side of the box. But Johnston's there. And coming so close. Very good, useful cross from Walter. Dragging the ball onto the right foot, and Johnson's coming goal side of his marker and just putting it past. Robertson getting the better of Nisbet. O'Boyle shielding it. Rafferty immediately set on by Walter. Rangers clear away out of trouble. Johnston to Walter. The point right. And oh, a chip that just carries over. Well, Mark Walter saw Westwater off his line. And this was worthy of Pelly. Watch this. Great vision from Walter here. Westwater desperately backpedaling. And almost a reminder of Pelly's attempts in the World Cup finals in Mexico. In control of this game now. the ball quickly. Cosma. Again the early ball. And again Dunfermline causing problems when they move it quickly and put pressure on the Rangers defence. The ball was dangerous one, putting pressure on Rangers, and it was Goff again to the rescue. Woodvey come right across here, he caught Johnston. Rangers still going forward. Irons winning that challenge for Spackman. Johnston still down as Dunfermline break to the other end. Threat coming from the right. Cosma. Oh, brilliant save by Wood. And the whistle has already gone for the challenge on Wood. The referee has blown the whistle for the foot in against Jack. And although the Dunfermline fans hope to raise for the ball was into the net, it won't count. It is a free kick. But this really was a terrific shot. And look how Wood gets down to smother it. Jack, you can see, kicks the ball into the keeper's hand. And although Boyle put it away, it didn't count. And Ridley and Johnston again, jousting. This time Johnston coming into the big central defender. And the free kick goes to the third one. So Patterson just making sure that Orange Johnston is told exactly why the ticket was given against him. Dunfermline beginning to come back into the game. Irons again. The shot not accurate enough. It was a good opening for him. Well set up, Irons kept going, and he certainly has got a good left foot, but this time with the right, was well wide of Chris Wood's left hand foot. Walters showing quite an appetite for the game. And Nicol taking him right out. Looks as if he's going to be the second Dunfermline player to be booked. That's just a ticking off. Mr. Goff is a quiet smile to himself. So Nicol escapes with a word of censure. And Walters prepared to take the free kick. Goff is up in the box. So is Johnston. Nisbet. Good turn. Goff and just over the top. Goff stayed up. And came close to getting Rangers second. Nisbet again showing good skill. Goff not able to get up and over the ball. Again Johnston penalised and he seemed to collide with Rugby more than anything else there. And Johnston taking it off on the shin. It looks as if Johnston is going to be booked for protesting. I think it may well be that plus a bit of persistent fouling. Quite. Played into the path of Johnston by Rugby. The referee waving play on with the Dunfermline player down. Johnston seems to catch him as he turns. Dunfermline still under a lot of pressure, but Stephen snatched at that one, and the move finishing up with a shot that was wild. Spackman getting to the byline, end of the Dunfermline defence under pressure. Johnston does the right thing, laying it off, but Stephen's a bit careless. Chapman wins so many balls in midfield for Rangers. Sets them on the counter-attack. Joining in again. Rugby, and it's just catching McCoy. Although Rugby seems to think it was a bit of a dive. But John Brown decides to have a goal. And again, he wasn't far away. Brown almost took everyone by surprise, and look how close he was. Deciding, right, enough is enough. Stuart Rafferty being pulled over. Involved in the incident with Spackman and the Dunfermline player, Stuart Rafferty, gets the yellow card. So it's time to take this. Dunfermline, try and break. Stevens coming across the path of Boyle, pushing him, and the Dunfermline player having a word with the referee. By our watch, the 45 minutes have come and gone. A couple of knocks taken, but not much stoppage time to be added on. Mitchell takes it, and the Rinder up time for the move to be completed. Rangers ahead by 1-0 at half-time. Gary Stevens getting the goal after 15 minutes. Good work by Nisbet setting it up, and Stevens put it away well to give Rangers a deserved lead. But Dunfermline, I'm sure, one or two nice touches, but they haven't had any luck near goal. Dunfermline get the second half underway, and I think they've got their sleeves rolled up an extra inch or two. Seems to be quite determined to get back into this game. Cosmas, trickery and skill. Rangers having to work hard to keep the server out. Backman rallying the defence. The Hungarian doing very well. Off there for Rangers. Coist in pursuit. McCarthy this time electing to use the pass back. Stevens pass intercepted by Robertson. Rafferty inside, bypasses him. And Munro steady and safe. Brilliant denied him. And that was a quality ball from Spackman. Stephen was through, the keeper to beat. And the fingertips of Westwater saved the day. Spackman. Goal playing into a rather tight zone. Now Nisbet. And that one curling, swirling in the wind, certainly hit quite strongly, and just carrying wide of Westwater's goal. This is showing good control, and just look how close this was. Keeper was well positioned. Walters taking over. Oh, and Westwater again alert. Walters looked very sharp. He was denied a goal early on when it was has cancelled out for an infringement, but Westwater has been very sharp, not happy with that clearance though. Walters cutting inside, going for the near post, and the keeper was there. Cosma, floated centre. Thurman again pressing, and Woods in trouble, and it's in, but it's been disallowed. The keeper was fouled by Rugby. And we see the high ball coming in here. Woods and Rugby literally leaping up at the keeper there. And although the ball did go in, Golf should have cleared it probably. Johnston, the choice wide on the right, picks him out perfectly. Rangers swarming forward. Gary Stephen again. McCoy has to settle for a corner. And I don't think Gary Stephen realised that he had the chance to go in there. Great ball through. And then he gave it back to McCoy when the shot was probably on. And McCoy won the corner. So with Dunfermline threatening at one end, Rangers turning the screw at the other within minutes. Well checked by Munro. Backlund always seems to be in space, always seems to be involved in the midfield action. Another great ball for Walters. Johnston in the middle, calling for it, but the shot went for the near post. Golf and Brown, as always for Rangers at the back. Johnston putting pressure on McCarthy. Certainly the pace of the Rangers attack in the closing 20 minutes or so of this second half might just be a telling factor. Nisbet, another lovely ball, and Stevens rattles it off the post. Almost a replica of the first half goal. The third one. Trying to hit back. That was Jack leaning in on Golf there, and that'll be the free kick for Rangers. Nisbet coming inside, winning it to Trent, winning it for McCoy. Johnston drifted out to the right. It seems to have taken a back knock in that challenge. Stevens to Walters. Trevor Stephen, the left foot snapshot. And it was Walters' skill in bringing that one down, and the neat layoff. The snapshot just wide. Dunfermline, despite Rangers afield, and Dunfermline surging forward, off Golf, and the Boyle was caught in two minds whether to have a shot or a lob, ended up with neither. This was Rafferty, bold effort, the deflection carried, and the Boyle should have done better. Boyle seemed to be pushed by Brown, but the referee waves play on, as this time McCoy tries to break, get away from McCarthy. Johnson's in the middle. He's back to Trevor Stephen. McFarlane have the defensive complement back. Walters takes over. Very tight space. And Johnston, and the header again, not able to direct it down. The toss just fractionally above him. Great skill from Walters, right to the byline. And Johnston needed another inch or two. But even so, Westwater had to be sure. For an opening. Irons. Rafferty. And Wood saw that one from a long way out. And again, an indication of Dunfermline's fighting spirit. Dunfermline supporters still staying here. They sense that their team could probably get something out of this. And Woods was there. That was almost a deflection off Brown. Again, Dunfermline pressing forward. And Dunfermline having a real go. Eddie Gallagher. Early ball. Brown deciding to take no chances, conceding the corner. An indication of the pressure that Rangers are now coming under. Gallagher, nice bit of play, getting the better of Goff. And it was Sharp's cross. So both substitutes involved in that threatening the Dunfermline attack. A hoist. That just taken away from Johnston. He gets another chance. And into the side netting after Westwater had brilliantly stopped Nisbet. That almost sealed it for Rangers. Westwater again defying them. A great ball from McCoy. Nisbet did well. And Westwater was the hero. And Johnston could pick up the crumbs. We're into stoppage time now. And Rangers holding on to a 1-0 lead. Brown getting it away. Rangers having to battle very hard indeed. As Rugby just cut out by Stephen. Boris Johnston and Westwater right in line in injury time. Two fine saves by the goalkeeper. Now here's Gallagher trying to break, but Stevens is back to assist Goff. The goal scorer for Rangers, and a vital goal that takes them a further step towards the championship. In stoppage time, as the Dunfermline still try and go forward. Tremendous fighting spirit from Dunfermline. By Goff, Spikeman and Stephen, Munro, but the final whistle goes, Rangers are the winners by 1-0. Gary Stevens after 15 minutes, the only goal between the sides, a gallant fighting performance by the Dunfermline in the second half, but not enough to deprive Rangers of even 1 point. Rangers, 2 points. 2 points near the championship.
Chris Woods, that was a very important result for Rangers today. Yes, very important. But you know, every game that we play is important. We always go out to win, and it's nice when you come off the pitch having done so.
And it was Gary Stevens who got the all-important goal.
Yes, yeah, we must be turning him into striker now. So he got a nice strike on the ball. He'll be pleased with that one.
Now, you yourself have played a major part in the Rangers' surge towards the title. That's 709 minutes without losing a goal. Are you really pleased with your form?
I'm pleased with my own form at the present time. It's a case of you know, getting your confidence back, which I think that I've done now. And hopefully I can go from strength to strength and you know, just get back to knowing, you know, playing out how I know that I can do.
And of course, Bobby Robson's called you back into the England squad.
Yes, well, I mean, again, that was basically down to injuries, and I just had to get back and prove my fitness and you know, just show him again what I can do. That's all it's about, really.
And of course, today your opposite number, Ian Westwater, he had a fine match too.
Yes, he played very well, and I can remember one save in particular, the one from Scott Nisbet where he got down with his left hand. It was a really good save.
And looking around the other results in Scotland today, very favourable indeed for Rangers.
Yes, they went well for us, but you know, that means nothing to us at the moment. We've just got to keep going, take each game at a time, make sure that we get 2 points every time that we go out, and you know, come May, hopefully.